Let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, that bouncing ball of brilliant buffoonery, Soupy Sales.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Right now, it gives me a great pleasure to welcome to the panel today the winner of this year's Golden Globe Award as the Best Dramatic Actress on Television, Linda Crystal.
And I would like to introduce a man I cannot live without, Alan Ladd.
Yeah.
There's no need. I want to tell you about a young lady that I first saw on Broadway.
Tell us about it.
All right. In Carnival, then I saw her in All America, then I saw her in Guys and Dolls, and I saw her in, Cabaret. Then I recently saw her in Jimmy, and she's always great. I'm talking about Anita Gillette.
She's shaggy.
I've been around a long time.
You do it all well.
That's not too classy, is it, yelling from the back?
No, I forgot that.
Yeah, I'm trying to be classy this week. Yeah. Now I'd like to introduce the head stowaway on this ship of fools, Mr. Wally Bruner.
Yes.
Thank you, Anita, and welcome to What's My Line. During the next 30 minutes, you're going to meet some interesting people engaged in the most unusual occupations, which we hope will baffle this panel of experts. And in addition, the panel will face a mystery celebrity guest just a little bit later on. But now, good group, shall we begin?
Yes, let's go.
All right, let's meet our first challenger. Would you enter and sign in, please? Susan Wetzel. Wetzel, where are you from?
Philadelphia.
All right. Panel, let me tell you that Susan Wetzel does not work alone, and that when she does whatever it is that she does, people watch. Now let's show the audience just what her line is. Let me remind you again, she does not work alone, and when she does what she does, people watch. And we'll begin the questioning with the absent-minded professor. Alan?
I can't remember the name of that great show. Okay. You do something with other... Don't do it alone, in other words. Does that mean, perhaps, for Susan, that what you work with is something other than people, as, for instance, animals? Do you work with animals?
Yes.
Oh, all right. Then it's some kind of a show business animal, because whatever you do with them, they watch doing.
That was a question, was it?
No, I'm just talking to myself. I can remind me what I'm thinking about. You know, Betty says when it comes in here, it goes out there. And so, all right, I'll organize my thoughts. Susan, is your work with animals in the form of an entertaining act?
No.
One down, Anita.
Maybe I should find out what kind of animal you work with. Would this animal be in the dog family?
No.
Two down, Soupy.
Do you work with what is known like as mammals?
Yes.
And now where do you go?
Where do I go?
That eliminates fish.
That's right. That's right. You don't close the eyes of the sardines before you put them in a can, do you? It's off, isn't it? Oh, anyway, Susan, you work with all kinds of mammals, or just one particular kind of mammal?
Well, which are you asking?
Well, I'll get around to it, Wally. I'm doing very well with her. Do you work like where you feed them, at some marina or something like that?
Yes.
Do you feed the porpoises?
No.
Three down, Linda.
Is these animals that you work with? Do you work with different kind of animals?
No.
That's four down, Alan.
Well, Soupy had it kind of fixed in his mind that the animals you work with are wet or in water.
He said or something like that.
Yeah.
And mammals.
Well, let me clarify something. Do the animals that you work with, are they other than the water mammals?
Yes.
They're land-type
yes.
animals. And it's not a show-busy kind of a work. Do you work in any kind of zoological arrangement, like a zoo, for instance?
Yes.
You do. You work in a zoo. Did you have anything to do with the care and feeding of the animals?
Yes.
Are you then indeed a feeder of the animals in the zoo?
We are after a specific animal.
Oh, a specific animal. All right. You just wouldn't challenge me like that, huh? I'll take a very big animal. Let's see. Do you work with elephants?
No.
That's five down. Anita.
This is not a water animal. Do you work with beasts of the jungle in any of that category? Like
yes.
Lions, tigers, that kind of thing. Would it be one of those cats?
No.
Six down, Soupy.
Is this animal, then it is a particular animal that, is this animal bigger than a lion?
In weight, yes.
Is it a hippopotamus?
No.
I'm going to flip all the cards and tell you that Susan is a nurse for baby gorillas.
Gorillas!
Miss Witzel is an animal technician at the Philadelphia Zoological Gardens in charge of their three baby gorillas. And what's the secret of taking care of baby gorillas?
Well, it's almost like taking care of small children. They need love, affection, play with them, feed them, care for them.
How old are they and how big are they?
They're about 2 years old now, almost 3 foot.
Are they still friendly and docile?
Oh, yes.
At what age do they get unfriendly?
Well, actually, they don't get unfriendly towards the keeper. They just get unpredictable, and they don't know their own strength. They can hurt you without knowing it.
After about age five or something like that?
Yes.
What do you feed them? What do they eat?
Well, in the morning, they get marmosette cake. This is a mixture of cereal, milk, eggs, and it has all kinds of things in it. And they get fruit all day long. They're fed all day long. That's to keep them practically happy. I guess they just feed themselves, and they get a bottle.
Well, I think we'd like to watch this in action, and Susan has brought with us some film that gives you a chance to see how much her gorilla babies behave like human babies. So would you describe the film, Susan, as we watch?
This is making up the bottle. When they first came into the zoo, they got pablum and milk. It's quite a feat feeding three gorillas at one time.
You have to burp them just like an ordinary baby?
No. They love to play, and if you tickle them, they actually just laugh at you.
How much time a day do you spend with them?
Well, I spend actually all day long from 8 to 5 in the morning, or 8 in the morning till 5 at night.
How old is that baby?
He's listening to a Soupy Sales record.
This is a little female gorilla. And this is male and female. They're playing.
Do they fight just like children?
Yes, they fight. This is an outside before they were put into the rare mammal house where they are kept now.
Do they bite at all?
Yes, they bite.
I notice they laugh. Do they also cry, Susan, when they're...
It's not actually a cry. It's sort of a whimper.
Well, that's very interesting. You have a very interesting job. Are they valuable animals?
Very valuable. It's around $4,500 they cost.
For each one?
Yes, each one.
Well, you have a delightful job and continue taking good care of them. And thank you for joining us on Let's Go. What's My Line? We'll continue right after this word. Off to a slow start, group. You're going to have to improve.
Yes, we
And here's the improvement challenger right now. You ready? Would you enter and sign in, please? Gerald Chappelle. Mr. Chappelle, where are you from?
New Canaan, Connecticut.
Am I saying your name correctly, sir?
Chappelle is correct.
All right. Panel, Mr. Chappelle deals with several products. One, however, we found very intriguing. Now, may I tell you that this is a product that normally has four corners. But Mr. Chappelle makes them without corners. And now let's show the audience just what this round product is. May I remind you, it's a product normally with corners. However, Mr. Chappelle makes it in a form other than square. And we'll begin with Linda.
The fact that you make it without corners, does it make your product more desirable to the public?
To some people.
Would I use your product?
Very much.
Would the product ever come in touch with my body?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, it would.
Without corners. And I use it a lot. Is it soft and silky?
Sometimes. It's could be, yes.
Mm-hmm. Does it have lace on it?
Lace? No lace.
No lace. That's one down, Alan Ludden.
I was going to be so smart. I was so sure that it was a round diaper, you see. I was convinced that the note was a round. But then he was so enthusiastic about Anita's use of it that I... Linda's use of it, I'm
Thanks,
sorry.
Yeah, I can live without him.
No, I just lost my... So it's not a diaper. Is it? It is indeed a fabric, though.
It has a fabric. It's made with fabric.
Whoop, don't help them too much.
It's made with fabric.
There's and fabric, it, but it's...
Linda would use it happily. Would I use it equally, happily? Mm.
Yes, you would use it.
I would. Is it anything I would carry on my person?
No, you wouldn't.
It's two down. Anita.
Is this product something that you would find around the house?
Yes.
Would it be found in one room more often than another room?
More often.
Would it be found around the kitchen more
no,
than...
No, it wouldn't.
Oh.
Three down, Soupy.
Is it... Did someone ask whether it was ever worn?
I don't believe anyone
has. Is it ever worn?
No, it isn't.
Four down, Linda.
Am I to assume that I would buy one then in a lifetime because it would never be worn out? Oh, I mean worn out. I mean, is it dispensable?
Is it dispensable? Well, it has a life.
Eventually it'll wear out.
It will wear out. Would you say that I would use it more in the bedroom?
Yes.
Would I use it in my bed?
I'd say that would be normal.
Appropriate.
Yes.
I would. Would I put it on?
No.
No. Five down, Ella.
She'd use it in her bed. Would I use it in my bed? It's not,
yes.
Yeah, we said
yes.
We both. Is it something I might, is it soft?
It is soft, yes.
Does it have an insides, something within it? Does it?
10 seconds.
Does it contain feathers? Is it a pillow?
No.
It's a round mattress. You're right, Anita. May I fully introduce Mr. Chappelle, who is Director of Marketing Bedding Products for the Simmons Company, makers of the round mattress. And I don't imagine these are on the mass production line, are they, Mr.
No,
Chappelle?
They're a very particular type of people that use them, but we sell quite a few.
Round people.
Isn't Hugh Hefner the famous owner of the famous round?
He has a huge one there in Chicago.
That's what I've
really
always
said. I assume you're talking about Hugh Hefner.
What'd I say?
I didn't hear you say it.
Hugh Hefner, yes.
Right.
Yeah.
And, is a round mattress more expensive than a square one?
Quite a bit.
What is the price range?
Somewhere between $900 and $1,000.
Oh.
How come?
Why?
Well, they're made on an individual basis rather than as mass production. And they have to be made very carefully to be sure that they'll hold up.
Do you also make round pillows going all around the mattress?
No, no round pillows.
What about sheets?
Sheets have to be custom made.
Where do you tuck them in?
Well, like a form fit.
Round form fit.
Or you could buy a little parachutes and
yeah.
Get the same effect.
How about heart shaped? Wouldn't that be terrific?
Heart shaped, we have made one.
You're kidding.
May I mention
it? Sure.
Jane Mansfield had one, and we also have made them for Liberace in the shape of a piano.
Oh, I think that'd be very comfortable.
Well, Mr. Chappelle, you stumped the panel, really, because time had expired, even though Anita did a very good job guessing it at the last moment. And we enjoyed having you on What's My Line. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
And say hello to the group. We'll be back to meet our mystery guest as What's My Line continues.
Once again, we have reached that very special part of What's My Line, the time we meet our mystery guest. Panel, are the blindfolds in place?
No.
Yes.
No?
Yes. No.
I just thought I'd say no because we always say yes.
You
know,
that's right.
That's what Arlene... No, mine's...
Put Anita in that chair and wow. No,
sealed?
Really, the blindfolds are in
yes,
place.
Sir.
So, mystery challenger, would you enter and sign in, please? Panel, may I remind you, it will indeed be one question at a time. I'll give you 2 minutes to try and establish the identity of our mystery guest, and we'll begin the questioning with Anita Gillette.
Thank you, Wally. Sir or madam, are you in some form of the entertainment world?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Soupy.
What was that?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. When you're in the entertainment...
Spell J-A.
Don't throw Soupy.
Go ahead, Soupy.
mystery guest, am I in town? Oh, mystery guest, are you best known for your work in a nightclub?
In nightclub, no.
That was a negative response.
No.
Linda.
He's not known in nightclubs.
Do you, can I assume that you work in television?
In television, little bit.
Alan.
Do you make records?
At what?
As a singer.
Singing in bathtub.
Singing in bathtub only?
In the bathtub
Is
only.
Is that a negative?
That's a negative. Anita?
Are you mostly known for your work in theater, then?
In Broadway, Hardway, no.
Soupy.
Well, did we establish that you were best known for your work in television?
I thought we had.
I don't even understand what he's saying. I'm looking for subtitles, and I've got a mask on. Wouldn't it be funny if it was Wally that was talking?
Was that a guess?
I don't even know. Are you best known for your work in television?
Television, yes.
That's a yes. Okay. Linda.
Do you have a serious at present time in television? Do you do a serious?
I do not have a serious. I have a funnies, not at all. I don't have a serious.
Alan?
Then you're a funny man. Are you a comedian?
If you don't know, I'm not going to try to help you.
I would never call my wife a comedian, Alan. Take off your blindfolds and meet Betty White.
She had this whole day lined up, would barely able to be over to get it for the last. You really aced me.
That's marvelous.
Let me see you do it.
You make one pass at this little old man tonight, I belt you.
You know, I thought they might do this, and then I thought, no, that's so obvious they won't do it, and I forgot it.
That's what I thought.
Well, we're so glad it's been done.
Oh, Wally, thank you so much. Had a delightful time. I'm going to go over and kiss 3 of those people on that panel.
Well, not yet. Not yet. What's new in the world of Betty White and Alan Ludden? Alan's been lying to us, you know, for all week. Now you're here, you can straighten everything all out.
He's been lying to me for almost 7 years. Well, we're having all sorts of interesting, delightful things. We both have a series in the works right now. And so it's finger crossing time.
You're living in California?
Living and loving it in California. Living and loving in California. I might as well leave it at that.
Yeah.
No, we really are. It's been a whole change for him. It's going home for me. But I'm happy as a lark, and I'm happy that my family likes it out there. So.
Yeah, I do all the things that Californians used to do and made me mad doing. I come back here and start saying, you got to move to California because it's so great. You know, I do the same.
But we turned our back on you and you got fragrant. That's what you did.
Fragrant?
Pregnant.
Me?
No, I'm the same as I always am.
Oh, it's Natalie.
Yes.
I get so confused about that. Okay.
But we, Betty and I, have a great thing with dogs. She's a dog lover, and so is my wife. And this is one of those rare times when we've been together that I've been able to talk, because it's usually, you know, one
Natalie
dog
and I go on about our dogs.
But Betty, we're delighted you could join us.
Thank you, Wally.
Thank you.
So nice to see you.
See you later.
What's My Line will continue right after this word. And now, panel, it's time for honest answers to questions from the studio audience. The first one from Robert Tutterman of Fairlawn, New Jersey, to Alan Ludden. How long have you been married to Betty White?
Well, you know, I'm glad you asked, because she said, she admitted for the first time a moment ago that we had been married 7 years. It will be 7 years this June, and she always says 6 years, and I say, it's only a couple of 3 months until, you know, now it's 2 months. No, we'll be married 7 years the 14th of June.
Weren't you doing a little theater in a play?
We were doing Summer Stock. I was doing Password. I met Betty on Password, and then I did Critics' Choice up in Dennis, Massachusetts, and they needed a leading lady to get the customers in, and they hired a young lady named Betty White, and she played my wife in the play, and I thought it was a good idea. It took me a while to convince her, but
well,
that was how we met.
You have told me that it was a stage kiss that really set things moving.
Well, that's the first time I kissed her, was on the stage.
Well, thank you for your honest answer.
And Alan, you watch it, Soupy.
Well, this has been a fun session again today, and we're going to have more fun tomorrow, because we got a, you know, a pretty sharp panel working for us over there.
I'm going to talk like this from now on. I'm not going to...
From now on?
From now on, I'm going to really talk like this.
Where does that big voice come from?
It comes from down my toes, actually, yes.
She's got the biggest toes you've ever seen.
Well, that's it for this session. Join us tomorrow, please.